Welcome to WebStylePress. Recently, I migrated a WordPress-based site to another server. Data migration was successful, but a site could not be loaded. Every time I tried to run the site, MySQL crashed. XAMPP crash, APACHE crash, or MySQL crash can be due to many reasons. It can be due to SSL issue, security software issue, firewall issue, blocked port issue, missing dependencies issue, improper privileges issue, or any other issue that causes site to crash. This problem is common, and I am going to give you few solutions. If I will share one solution, it might not work for you. I am going to share all possibilities that I have seen. See this XAMP control panel? See this error. MySQL shutdown unexpectedly. This may be due to blocked port, missing dependencies, improper privileges, a crash, or a shutdown by another method. Press the logs button. These are logs for APACHE and these are logs for MySQL. You can investigate the issue by looking at the log file. Log files for MySQL and APACHE can be accessed from this panel. Logs for APACHE are here. Logs, APACHE, error logs, error.log. Look for the latest timestamp. Scroll all the way down. Look for the error log in front of latest timestamp, and you might find the relevant error that you're looking for. For MySQL, click logs. Click at MySQL underscore error.log. Scroll all the way down. See this MySQL D got exception. So error logs will give you a clue about the actual issue that you can further troubleshoot. To troubleshoot and solve issues with XAMPP, MySQL or APACHE, try these methods. Method number one, run XAMPP as an administrator. Do not jump into conclusion that it is port or corrupted data issue. First, go to XAMPP installation folder. Right-click at xampcontrol.exe, go to properties, then compatibility, and check the option that says run this program as an administrator. Stop APACHE and MySQL, restart XAMPP, and see if problem is solved. Number two, security or SSL plugins. Again, do not jump into conclusion that it is port or corrupted data issue. First, try to launch any other site or page from same server. If other sites or pages are running, then obviously your site has some issue. Disable security software plugins like WordFence Security or SSL plugins like Really Simple SSL plugin, or you might have Easy HTTPS Redirection plugin. Disable these. To disable plugins, you can also rename plugin from plugins directory temporarily. When you migrate site, especially between localhost and live server, make sure you disable SSL and security plugins first, then take backup and then migrate. After migration is done and you see this site, then enable relevant plugins that you disabled. It is most likely that you will encounter this issue during site migration. So remember to avoid this mistake. See this site. This site is working fine. And now, XAMPP control panel is working. APACHE and MySQL are working. And if I see this site and I hit reload button, now, as you can see, MySQL D.exe has stopped working. Exception code, fault module name. It seems like that MySQL has crashed. As you can see, this error from here. But it is not. Let me cancel this reload. And this is another site at same server. I will stop APACHE I will start Apache and MySQL again. And now I can access this website at same localhost without any problem. As you can see, this is working. So this website is crashing MySQL, but this site at the same server isn't. So the problem is not with the port, problem may be with the site. That was fixed by disabling security and SSL plugins before migration for this website. It took me 5 migration attempts to understand this issue. Make sure you don't make this mistake. Number 3. Port issue, Skype or another PHP server installation issue. Often web developers install XAMPP and then WAMP also. This creates conflict in ports. I also have made this mistake several times. Skype and such software also use similar port as XAMPP does. That common port is 8080. If you see port conflict issue in error logs, make sure Skype is not using same port, or make sure any other software is not using same port. You can change port used by Skype from Skype settings. Any port sniffer program or task manager can also show you used ports by relevant programs, or you can change ports for MySQL and Apache from XAMPP Control Panel. To change ports, click at this config button, then click at service and port settings. For Apache, you can mention the port here. You can choose to use any port here, any number here. And then for MySQL, you can change the port from here and then click save button. But by doing this, ports will not be changed. For Apache, you'll have to click at this config button and then go to httpd.conf file. Here you will see this listen 80. You'll have to change the port here for Apache as well. That you changed there. Also, change that port here as well, in front of server name localhost colon 80. Change it here as well. Then for MySQL, click at config and then my.ini. Here you will see the port here, 3306. Change it. And here as well. Search for port in these files and you will find the port. Then you can change these ports. And for MySQL, if you change the port from here, you'll have to do one thing more. You'll have to go to phpMyAdmin from XAMPP folder and update config.ini.php file. That is this file. This is the original line. If you change the port, let's say from 3306 to 3307, in front of this IP address, you'll have to use colon and specify that port. After doing that, restart XAMPP Control Panel and ports will be changed and you can avoid ports conflict next time. Number 4. Reinstall XAMPP. If phpMyAdmin is working, then this method is for you. Only start MySQL and go to phpMyAdmin. Let's say the conflict is due to Apache and Apache is not working for some reason, but MySQL is working. You can start MySQL and go to phpMyAdmin, localhost/phpMyAdmin, and these are all of my databases. You can hit this export button to export all these databases as a backup. Once you have taken the backup, after you install latest XAMPP, you can import that DB file from here. But also from your XAMPP folder, make sure you copy this htdocs folder, because it contains file system of your sites. Data for your sites is in htdocs folder and databases are in phpMyAdmin. So you have to export the databases from phpMyAdmin and copy this htdocs folder. Then rename this XAMPP folder in your hard drive. Download and install latest XAMPP, copy htdocs folder in it, import databases file, and you will have your old data back, including databases and your websites. So reinstalling XAMPP is another way to counter these issues. Number 5. Data folder issue. This is one of last resort. If nothing else works, go to MySQL folder in XAMPP. MySQL folder, and as you can see, data folder here. Ignore this data underscore copied. So I am renaming this data folder underscore old. It is not working because it is being used. So I'll have to stop the servers and then try again. And now this is my old data folder. Now I am creating another folder named as data, and it is empty right now. So I renamed data folder and then created a new data folder. Then I will go to backup folder that is provided by the XAMPP for such situations. I will copy whole data and all files from the backup folder and paste inside data folder. Then I will go back and I will go to data old folder and I will copy all these folders. These are folders for databases. More the databases, more folders. But I will have to skip two folders from here. Number 1, phpMyAdmin, and number 2, performance underscore schema. Don't copy these folders. Copy all other folders from here. Go back, go to data folder, and paste those folders here. Replace folders. Replace files. If it asks. Okay, so databases folders have been copied here. Now go back. Go back to old data folder. Look for this file, ibdata1. Copy this file. Go back. Go to data folder. Paste this file here, replace, and that's it. Now restart XAMPP and run Apache and MySQL again. Now your sites will work. So in case data folder is corrupted, you can use this method to revive that folder and revive your sites and databases. Alright, now these are 5 methods that I have mentioned. Carefully take backup first and try these one by one. When a method works, don't go further and stop there. Okay, do let me know which method worked for you. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.